Combined History in Great Britain, we are European champions for 10 years. We have lost the crown. And I believe there's a reason, because a philosophy or a way of training that Paul Hall introduced a very long time ago, which we all follow, which I choose to share with you today. The success of it is based on the coach, not on the gymnast. The coach is lazy, the gymnast is lazy. If the coach is angry, the gymnast will have anxiety and stress. Anxiety and stress on pommel course, without it, is not the good thing to have. So it is impossible to teach pommels as an angry coach. Oh, you must do this, you must do that. You must be enthusiastic. Encourage work. There are 3 points for pommels. Simple points. Mechanics, which I will talk very, very simply about. Physiology, you must be strong. Very, very strong shoulders. You must be able to do a lot. And the final part is psychology. That is the three main things of pommels. Three main of all of the apparatus. The psychology of pommels is you must be disciplined. You must endeavor. You must have belief. You must be disciplined. Do every day, you work hard, your maximum every day. You must endeavor. Endeavor means you never ever quit. Never give up. Never stop. Never just drop off. You must always fight to stay on the horse. And they must believe. You must have belief. You must believe you can do it. You can believe that you can be the best on pole. How, as a group of coaches, do we teach this to our children?
If you have to be in the exact same. These children, from a very young age, will mirror your behavior. You, as a coach, have to be disciplined to go to pommels with a plan. I watched pommels yesterday. There's no plan, just the kids do whatever they want to do. You have to have a plan and a structure of training. You have to believe that they can do pommel. A coach who goes to pommel and thinks, oh, I don't like pommel. They always fall off. The gymnast will always fall off. And a coach who quits because the gymnast is too small and they can't do it, also the gymnast will quit. So the psychology comes from the coach. Mechanics in the circle? There are 3 details I like to think about on pommels, that is all. And those 3 details I would apply to the routine. Go, Josh! So, for me, the first point, what makes the circle move? And for me, the most important thing is the shoulders. So, the shoulders make the circle. Okay, so mechanics of the circle, we have to do something with these. We must do something with the shoulders. Yeah, that's it. That's all I need to think about. When you come to learn Stockley's or Kuznari or Magyar, the shoulders. Yeah? We want to look at the hips. Cross circles to the right. Always there is a hip turn. Yeah? Josh always feels tension in his hips. Where do you feel tension, Josh? We're on at this side, opposite side from the circle. Okay? If I circle this way, my hips must be locked in the opposite direction. Work against the circle. The circle turns this way, your hips fix again. That way you always feel tension, each circle. Each circle tension, which leads to stability. Okay? That's the second detail. And the final thing for me is how you accelerate, how you make the circle go quicker. So if the circle is slow, or if you're making a mistake and you're going to fall, I'm going to fall off, most gymnasts fall off. Not my gymnasts. My gymnasts know how to create rotation or to create speed. And they do that by the circle. So from the right, go. Hips, heel. Hips, heel, hips, heel, hips, heel. Yeah? Josh, as he passes here, as he comes to here, his hips pass his hands. It doesn't have to be in an arch, it can be straight. And when he comes here to accelerate, he uses his glutes, his bottom, yeah? In a straight line. Not like that. It must feel. They spin here, I always have tension here, like loose, lose support, lose balance, and fall. Must always do attention here. So here, hips at the front, and heels at the back.
So your hips and your glutes. Those three simple things are all I think about when we go to the horse to do technical skills, Magyar, Shimano, stop please, one-handed circles. Usually the mistake is the shoulders are not balanced, the hips are not supported, so they lose support, or they don't use their hips, they don't use their glutes. Only those three mistakes happen, they make a fall. That's it. That's all I think about. Psychology, these three things. Mechanics, these three things. Physiology, simple. You have to have strong shoulders. Very, very strong shoulders. The endurance from the shoulders is massive. And the most important thing, you have to have ridiculously strong shoulders. And now I'll show you how to get strong shoulders. This is my team. When you do pommels, I'm the boss. Yeah? When they are young, okay, I like them. When I talked about the plan A, we give them free training, they decide. When they are young, very young, when we start before they can circle, I must be in charge. These are my pack of dogs. Yeah? Very, very young children, they have to work very, very hard. Pommels has to be organized. They arrive, they know the circuit. I have the stopwatch. I have my pen. I'm ready. Boys, you ready? Yes? Okay. The biggest mistake the coach makes is you begin to circle too soon. So straight away, we come to pommels, you teach them front support, you teach them side support, back support here, and then we go on the mushroom. Yeah, and we tap practice. The body is not prepared. The body is not strong. They don't know the mechanics. They don't know what the shoulders do. They don't know how the hips need to be fixed. They don't know how the hips and the glutes, they don't understand how to work. They're too small, they're not strong enough. So you must educate them, you must show them the things that they need to learn so that when you get on a pommel horse, it will be easy. So exercise number one, this is good. Yeah? Elbows must be straight. The head must be in line with the spine. Many people yesterday circled like this, or like this. So you teach them to be here, eyes and hips. Hips, what did we say about the hips? Come on.
Fixed.
Yes. Toes pointed. Okay, too much hips. You see hips?
No,
fixed.
Stay strong.
Faster. Knees straight. Okay, so again, the rules you teach the gymnast, the rules. Eyes forward, here, nice straight spine, hips tight, and circle. Arm by ears. Go. Go. Okay, what does he have to do to circle his arms? Keep going.
To balance.
Lean. Left side. So we teach the gymnast how to lean. We also teach the gymnast where the handle is. Yeah? Keep facing me. Okay, so here they learn hips. Hips, heels. Okay? And up. Body straight. Push. Bigger push. Out. Come on. Four. You see, add on the difference between the Italian gymnast and British. But his fixed, his hips are one. The Italian wasn't more along. He's straight. Yeah? Go. Fix. Yeah? See? Straight body. Unfortunately. It's a good idea, straight arms, fantastic, you have to do that as part of your system. But the exercises, you have to think about why you're doing the exercises, what they're used for, the quality of the exercises, do I need to support the exercise, what are the key details. So the point of our circuit is to get strong, but also to teach them what they do with their shoulders, what they do with their hips, if they've got movement, if their core is tight and fixed. It's not just to move around, or it's a total waste of time. Boys, we practice for 30 seconds without stop. You must be disciplined, and you must believe you can do it, and you must endeavor. Anyone quit, I get angry. Are you ready? Three, we're gonna do 30 seconds work, and then 10 seconds to move to your next station.
Two, 10, 30,
together. Yeah, we do it together. We learn together. 10, 20, 30, 50, 60. How many can you do? 110, 120, 200, 300, 400, as many as you can. That's it. There's no other magic way. Just by the same psychology, belief, discipline, never give up. But those simple methods to learn a circle. Once you can circle, then you need to get strong. I like the bucket. The bucket you could do as part of the progression, you know, the training that we did there. Nice exercise, similar to the rings. Yeah? As well as that, you can have the... Yeah, perfect. As well as that, as well as the circuit that we did for preparation, you can have the exercise that Rosanna did, yeah, on the springboard. You can have, yeah? Many things. Be creative. Think what you could use, yeah? Okay, so then after that, we start to do thousands of circles. We have to do hundreds, hundreds, hundreds. There's lots of ways you can do it. But what we'll do is a simple way. So Adam, you count. Josh. Yeah, Josh does circles for 30 seconds. You count. Yeah? You count. Yeah, you count. How many he does. Okay? And again, as a common coach, you must have a pen. You write down. Do not fall off. Okay? 30 seconds. 30 seconds, 30 seconds. On pommels, what is the big rule in the competition? Don't fall off. So, from a very young age, you teach them not to fall off the horse, to suffer, to have discipline, to endeavor. Yeah? Boys, you ready? Guys, you count, yeah? 3, 2, 1. Not every day. maybe twice a week, two times, maybe three, usually twice a week, 1,000 4 to 5 minutes. Eventually, not dictated by me, at the moment I dictate how they do it. As they get older and as they get better at it, we set them a target. I say 45 minutes to do 1,000 circles. I give them some rules and I watch their own psychology, whether they can continue to do it on their own. Yeah? If we put them together like that, which one do you think would be better on pommel? For me, the Swiss gymnast would be better on pommel because his arms are long, he has no waist, he has a long beard, perfect for pommel horse. This one, short arms, a bit funny looking, yeah? But I bet you he will be better on pommel because he follows this system. Yeah,
so the program I will do, we do six sessions a week and you alternate. Quantity, technical, skills. Quantity, technical, skills. Yeah?
The wrist. If you have problems with the wrist, it's because you didn't prepare in the beginning. You didn't prepare the body well enough to do this. If you do this gradually, you should never have to wear wrist support. I would use this program up to 14 years old. After 14 years old, just do 50 circles on the handles or 60 circles on the handles. It's enough because they do many combinations, many routines. But from 7 until 14, you have to use it in your program. Alright, so you can circle now, so you're nice and strong. You're physically prepared. Yeah, your gymnast can do 1,000 circles in 45 minutes. They're very, very strong. You have a good circle, good quality. What do you do next? Where do you start? What do you need to think about? So next is methodology. How do you go from the practical aids on the floor to using the pommel horse? For me, there are a couple of key technical movements that you have to be able to do. The first three, you have to be able to check. So turn in the same direction as your circle. The other way is to turn the same direction is to stop with. So you must turn with your hand behind your back. And you must be able to spindle. So turn in the opposite direction. So those three methods. The three things that you have to begin first on the motion to teach the gymnast how to do. Okay? Coaches, what would you say about the problems, what issues we have?
Hand placements.
Hand placements, what's wrong with hand placements?
Not enough turn.
Not enough turn, yeah, so we've got a problem already. So straight away, before I even look at the horse, I have some issues I need to resolve with that. What about his circle?
Slow, too pike.
Too slow, pike, no hips, many problems. Yeah, so start again. When you have problems on pommel, start to slow down. Okay, two movements. Check and stop it. You must learn to do them on here perfectly. Yeah, to do them well. If things start to go wrong, stop, slow down. Do one circle, check, one circle, check. Let's watch for the hips. Yeah, watch for his hips. Okay, jump. Now, two, and check.
and stop. And again, loop, one loop and on the second one. Now, check, here, and stop. And again, loop, and check, here, and stop. Again, mistake there, too early with the hand. And stop, and check. Okay, so first check, second stop. Third thing, spindle. Spindle's good because it corrects the circle, so you have to make it turn to do spindle. They count for everything. So on pommel, McGilney is a Stockley. Yeah. Wu is a Russian. A Stockley, a Czech. All there's four. Not many movements on the pommel. But you have to master them on the mushroom
first.
Yeah. Okay. So again, start with one. Go. Then two. You should learn both. The gymnasts have to be able to go forward or orthodox, Russian, backwards. Because when you come to do Wu, you have to go forward and backwards. Young, straight away with young children, youngest age, learn to make a routine on the pommel and with the judging. Salute, have a routine. Then you have a bit better success when you come to the horse. Audience. Yeah, really important part of pommels. Come on. Spin. Come on, not four. Routine. Russian. Check. Stop. And land. That's it. Target with a young child, 8, 9, 10, 11 years old, or 9, 10 on here, to have a confident gymnast. A gymnast who comes and wants to show off. Yeah, I'm going to do a good routine, massive stuff. He thinks for himself. I make the routine, I can do flares, I can do double Russian, I can do half check, I can do check, check, I can do extra loop. He starts to think, yeah, for himself. Come on, Adam.
next bit with coaches, my problem is the coach goes straight from the mushroom. Your next port of call is here.
Yeah, the leather or the...
What happens when the coach goes to here, different surface, and the gymnasts begin to, on the hot horse, they're nice and square, when they come to here, they begin to skew, and you have a hard time. I think, I don't know, the new surface is different. For me, it's better to go learn from Tao here. At the moment, his hands are really small. There's a big surface area, easy to balance. His hands can be sideways. Yeah, it's exactly the same as here. Not different. Yeah, and also if his hands are this way on your circle, when he comes around, he can put his hand on early. This is the problem when you come here. You go loop, you put your hand down too soon. You need to wait till you're square. If the hands are on backwards or sideways, it's impossible to put the hand on early. You must wait. Notice the hips fixed. Don't change. Oh, now the hips change. Also, this way, it's easier to balance. Yeah, you can cheat. That way, you can't cheat. You must be completely parallel if you want to do a good circle. Yeah. Usually, when his right hand goes down, if his hand was this way, he should cheat. He'd put his hand down early and continue to go. But because his both hands are that way, he can't cheat. Much easier to cheat. He come right out of the field, oh, quickly put his hand on and look around. Much better to learn like that than be a hand back.
Five by that, five by that.
Do we watch for his hips?
These circles are much better like this.
Big difference like this or like that, because this way, when he comes round here, he can put the hand on much earlier. This way he has to wait. Yeah, until he's fully round. Which is the same problem will be when you come to do inward loop, outward loop. Mm-hmm.
Just do like that, yeah.
It's up to you as a coach, your decision, but my opinion would be straight from the pommel. You must learn that exercise first. Of course, you cannot step up on the handle with the hand backwards. You just do 10 circles forward and then.
Yeah. Good circles, please, please.
What about Josh's head? He's focused, he's in the same position. His hips are tight. Right arm, hip. His hand doesn't matter what he does with his hands or his body, his belly button always stays. It works from the feet. Now stop.
So what we achieve stability.
Okay, learn Czech, learn Scotland, learn Finland, learn Russian, learn travel with action. Again, be precise with the hand. So loop.
Am I in the way?
Okay, half spindle, okay. Loop. Loop on the half spindle. Go. And up. Next. Yeah? Again, what do we need to be precise with? Hand placement. Exactly where it needs to be stable before we move on. If it's not stable on the leather, if it's not stable on the mushroom, if it's not stable on the low situation here, we'll never be stable. Good. Good.
So again, play, have a routine here with many elements. Play, have a routine here with many elements. Play, have a routine here. That would be my first, second, third. Four stages you need to is movement. Travel forwards, travel backwards. I would always start with Shibado. With Shibado you have an obstacle to hit, so you have to do a better circuit. Yeah? Maybe how you can pike and you think you're doing well. Shibado straight away, if you do wrong, you're a bit hard. Much better to start with Shibado. Yeah? A good way of stopping the children from skewing is to start with coffee.
Again, the numbers, when we're doing, so we did endurance.
physical day where we do lots of training. We have a technical day which is just basic. So basics might be, Josh, you circle in the middle. If I have a technical day, I only focus on basic elements. Basic there, maybe I put crash mats level with the handles, I do good basic circles with them. That's the second day. But the third day is skills, it's fun. Has to be elements on the mushroom, elements here with movement, lots. So you make the next thing is to try to, for me, the next thing to do is to travel the horse. Magyar, classic Shibala. Element in gymnastics, you have a backflip, you have to separate it into sections. So if we look at Shivado, you never did Shivado. No? You have to choose which part. So I like to start at the end of the element. Practice 5 minutes. You have to do Shivan. Okay? 5 minutes. Go. Okay? Just play. Carry on. Toes. Okay, look. Psychology as well is to create teams of gymnasts and coaches. Sitting down. So already they want each other to achieve. I want you to learn a skill, I want you to do a magnet, I want you to do this. I create that because I'm the coach. You guys want to create that as coaches with your gymnasts, with your athletes. They want each other to achieve something. Benny, everyone wants you to do this, yeah? Come on. Initially, it's very, very hard work. The coach will sweat, the coach wants to work very, very hard. But once you work very, very hard, you then have an opportunity to enjoy them playing and to try all different kinds of things. Coach has a method to teaching the skill and has an idea of how you break it down.
in any of the apparatus in gymnastics, then you will have success. And the gymnast will enjoy himself, you will enjoy yourself. If you think that you just learn a Magyar by standing in front of the horse and thinking, please, you get across, or you practice here and you don't have a method or a way for the gymnast to do it, then it's very, very important. Yeah? Any questions? No? If not, that's all I wanted to say. Iago, the three things. Make sure your gymnast is strong, train that once in the week. Make sure you are technical, train that second time in the week. Third time in the week, play. Let them play, let them have fun, let them do different things, and then repeat. Endurance, strength, technical, play. Endurance, strength, technical, play. And that's the point.
Okay, thank you very much.